dolls. I am. What am I doing? I'm driving to get something to eat because I'm hungry. I'm hungry, hungry, hungry. So I'm going to go get something to eat. It is Friday for me. I don't know what day it is for y'all. It may be Sunday or Monday. I'm not sure when I'm going to post this one. But anyway, as y'all know, I'm doing the sale in my house. And to be completely honest with y'all, I did this kind of as an experiment. You know, to share a video and also to get rid of some of my inventory. If you're just now tuning in, I sell things online. So that's what I do. But, and a lot of other things, but specifically what I'm talking about right now is that. So I just, took down my sign, and like I said, it's Friday. It's only about 1:13. I had posted the ad in Craigslist that I'd be there till 2:00. And of course, when I pull a sign down, a sign's down. So anybody that would have been driving by to see it, you know, obviously aren't going to see it. So, but to let y'all know, if you know, that's the beauty of having a garage sale or whatever, is if you make the money that you want to make, then you can pull up your signs, you know, and take your ads down on Craigslist. If you put it in a paper, you're kind of out of luck because you've got to stay open for the times, you know, that you posted it in. Well, you don't have to, but you know, that's just good business in my mind. It's just being, having integrity. But anyway, oh, I lost my train of thought. I was going to say something so insightful. And now I can't remember what it was. What was I saying? I pulled the signs down. Oh, and it's early. So, you know, that's, I guess that's what I was trying to say. Obviously not very relevant, but, what I'm going to do now is I've pulled all the ads down off of Craigslist that said it was like a personal liquidation that was going to go on for weeks and all this kind of stuff. I do have an event up on Facebook for my local followers here in Austin, but I've only gotten one guy that said he was going to come by. Three girls said they might come by. And one guy asked how much one particular item was. So what I'll probably do now is go back and update that event because it was like ongoing, and I'll say, if you're interested in anything, let me know. You know, continue to watch my videos, and I'll keep posting things that I have listed for sale. So that's how you can do that end of it. I don't think I did share that with y'all before about posting a Facebook event. If you're having a sale, garage sale, yard sale, something like that, do a Facebook event. If you don't know how to do one and you want me to do a video on that, you're going to have to leave me a comment below asking me to do that. And if you're watching from another website where you cannot comment below, you still should be able to comment below. So do that, like if it's on one of my blogs or something. Okay, so there's that. So now what I'm going to do for the next demonstration or whatever for all you guys and dolls is I'm going to go and do, because a lot of this, okay, pause. Now here's, you know, another part of it. A lot of this stuff that I'm selling is inventory. So it has either been up on Amazon or it's been up on eBay for a long time. I'm sick of looking at it. I want it gone and I want some cash. So obviously it's not selling as individual items. So what I'm going to start doing now to see if it works again is do a mystery box. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to theme them. So like the headline on, I'm going to do them all on eBay. And so like the headline will read something like, free shipping mystery box theme romance novels, or it'll say theme children's books, and then in parentheses it might say like preteen or middle school age or something like that, or it'll say theme men's clothing and then I'll give a size, or theme ladies clothing and I'll give a size, or theme craft items, you know. But what I'm gonna do is how you do a mystery box. First of all, don't put a bunch of garbage in there. I've seen some videos of people opening their mystery boxes, and some of the stuff they get, you know, is pretty cool. Like a guy got some brand new, you know, earbuds in a package, but then they put in like a piece of plastic tubing that was like 4 inches long, and I was like, what? That's nothing but trash. That's a piece of trash. They could have, you know, whoever shipped it, they could have recycled that. I mean, it was just like plain old, about that big around, plastic tubing. I thought, okay, that was really lame. But My mystery auctions aren't that way. My mystery boxes are always always have really cool stuff in it. So I'm going to try that out, and we'll see the results on that. So all told this week, and this is kind of pitiful numbers, and honestly, this is not normally my numbers. I'm thinking now in retrospect, this week was not a good week to do it because it's Memorial Day weekend this weekend. And of course, me being a ding-dong, nilly, willy-nilly, silly, goofy, crazy woman, I didn't realize so much that it was, goodness gracious sakes, there's lots of people where I want to go. So I'm going to go to the light and turn left. Turn it left across the traffic. Some of y'all really liked that in the video I did the other day when I was doing all that silly singing. So there was a little bit for you again. But anyway, do you like how I ramble? Does my brain distract you? Because it distracts me a lot. Sometimes I wonder if I'm ADD, but if I am, I'm very high-functioning ADD because I've always been, you know, right up there. But anyway, okay, so what am I saying? Yeah, the mystery boxes. So if you're interested in a mystery box of mine, okay, you need to go to my eBay. I was going to say my eBay channel. Please go to my eBay channel. You need to go to my eBay account, or what is it called? I don't know. What do they call it? Your eBay profile? I don't know. But anyway, there is a link. If you're on YouTube right now watching this video, there's a link in the description below. So you can just go there, click it, and go and see what I have for sale. Okay, if you're not watching this, then you would need to go to, let me think how it works again. I think it's eBay. Oh man. Now I'm saying that. You know what? Forget my mouth. Forget what I'm trying to say. Wesley, editor for Wesley, put in a link. Not a link, but a annotation. Put an annotation somewhere, like over here or something, of what my eBay thing is. My eBay site. I don't know what to call it. Oh, my eBay site. Okay, for that. Now, if you are watching this, right now it's May of 2012, all right? I list my auctions for like 5 days or so, 5 to 7 days. Depending on how it goes, I will relist if I don't get any, you know, if I don't sell them all. But if you're watching this 3 or 4 years down the road, I probably don't have any mystery boxes up. Unless mystery boxes became evident to me that that was the way to sell things on eBay, and then there might be a whole bunch over there. But what I'm saying is that any videos around this time that you're watching, if you're trying to find those items in mystery auctions or mystery boxes, those items probably will not be available anymore, but other things would be. Good Lord, this person has a bumper sticker on their car that says Republicans for Voldemort. Seriously, that's ridiculous. I'm a Republican, but you wouldn't know it by the way that I do things and stuff. But anyway, that's a whole nother topic. I have rambled sufficiently, I think, to probably bore y'all to death. So I'm so sorry if you have died during this video due to my boring ramblings. So click off right now and go get yourself a reviving refreshment. And, yeah. Okay, I'm putting out the first sign, and it's right here on a major cross street. And here's the sign. And you can see the little prong that comes with it. Now this is a heavy duty sign, but you see how big the letters are, and it just has an arrow, okay? And it's pointing the direction that the sale is going to be, which is down here. I don't have an address on it. There's different schools of thought on the address. I don't think it's necessary a lot of times, unless you're in like a windy neighborhood area, and then you might want to put on the address. But generally speaking, just having the big bold letters and the arrow, because see, I'll show y'all how far back. See, it's pretty bold. And black on white, to me, is the best most visual is that, you know, think about street signs. You know, they do it for a reason. They do the green background with the white font or whatever for a reason. They do the white sign with the black lettering for a reason. They do yellow sign with black lettering for a reason. They do red sign with white lettering for a reason. And I'm having a hard time getting the car turned around this morning. But what you want to do when you put your signs up is you want to start, the best way to do it is start the furthest out. And then, you know, as you get closer, like if you're going to do multiple signs, do the furthest one out. And then do like a spiral in. I'm only doing two, so that doesn't really apply. Also, if you have more than one person, leave somebody behind so they can go ahead and catch any, you know, early birds that get the signs from the far out part. Another thing to do, which is the cardinal rule, which I'm breaking today, and that is you need to have change on hand. Now, a lot of times if you're having a garage sale, you ain't got no monies, and that's why you're having your garage sale. But generally speaking, you really, really, really need to have cash on hand for change for people. So what I usually suggest, just the easy way to do it, is a roll of penny, nickels, dimes, and quarters. Majority ones, lots of fives, some tens, and maybe a 20 or two. And generally, I do about $75, $50 to $75 in change. So I'm going to put out the other sign and go in the house, and then I'll probably talk at you guys and gals later. More tips in a little while.